हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ साइंस क्लास 7 चैप्टर 13 मोशन एंड टाइम। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट द पैरामीटर्स दैट इंडिकेट्स हाउ फास्ट और स्लो एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूविंग एंड वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बेसिक टर्म रिलेटेड विद मोशन लाइक स्पीड, एवरेज स्पीड, यूनिफॉर्म मोशन एंड नॉन यूनिफॉर्म मोशन। So let us start. First, let us understand what is the meaning of motion. Students, as we have already read about the motion in previous class, that an object is said to be in motion when it changes its position with respect to a stationary object such as a building or an electric pole. Students, the motion may be of different types. Some basic types of motion are rectilinear motion, curvilinear motion, circular motion and periodic motion. Students, we have discussed in the previous class that the motion along a straight line such as the motion of a car along a straight road is called rectilinear motion and the motion along a curved line is called curvilinear motion and the motion along a circular path is called circular motion. Students, motion of an object can be slow or fast. An object is said to be moving slowly if it covers less distance at a given time in comparison than to other objects which cover more distance at the same time. बच्चों, क्या आपने कभी किसी एथलेटिक मीट में पार्टिसिपेट किया है? एथलेटिक मीट्स में डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पार्टिसिपेंट्स सेम टाइम में डिफरेंट डिस्टेंस कवर करते हैं। जो सेम टाइम में ज्यादा डिस्टेंस कवर करता है वो फास्ट होता है और जो सेम टाइम में कम डिस्टेंस कवर करता है वो स्लो होता है। नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म स्पीड। स्पीड इज द डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड बाय ए मूविंग बॉडी इन यूनिट टाइम, 1 सेकेंड, 1 मिनट और 1 आवर्स। In other words, we can write a formula for speed, speed equal to total distance covered upon total time taken. Now, let us understand the units of speed, how we will measure the speed. The standard unit of speed is meter per second or meter per second or meter upon second or meter inverse second. These are the units of speed. And students, now let's take an example. A car covers a distance of 100 km in 5 hours. Calculate its speed. And the solution will be the total distance covered equal 100 km. And the total time taken by the car is 5 hours. We know that the formula of the speed is distance upon time. So, the distance is given 100 km. And the time is given 5 hours. So, we will put up the value in the formula of the speed and when we solve this out, then we will find 20 km. So, the speed of the car will be 20 km per hour. And students, now let us understand the term speedometer and odometer. Speedometer and odometer are the two types of meter which are installed in motorbikes and in motor vehicles. The speedometer measures the instantaneous speed of the vehicle, while the odometer measures the distance moved by the vehicle. And students, now let us understand the conversion of kilometer per hour into meter per second. Students, we know that 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. And we also know that 1 hour equal to 60 minutes and 60 minutes will equal to 60 into 60 seconds, that is 3600 seconds, or we can say 1 hour have 3600 seconds. So 1 kilometer per hour will be 1000 meter upon 3600 seconds. This will be equal to 5 upon 18 meter per second. It means 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 5 upon 18 meter per second. Thus, if a car travels with a speed of 54 km per hour, then its speed in meter per second will be, the speed of the car is 54 km per hour. So, we will multiply the 54 value with 1000 upon 60 into 60 seconds. So, this will be 54 multiplied by 5 upon 18. And this will equal to 15 meter per second. So, if a car traveling with a speed of 54 km, then its speed in meter per second will be 15 meter per second. And students, now let us understand the term average speed. The average speed is calculated by the distance that an object traveled over a given interval of time. In other words, we can calculate the average speed of an object by applying the formula average speed equal to total distance traveled upon total time taken. And now let us understand the non-uniform motion. When a moving body covers unequal distance in equal interval of time, its motion is said to be non-uniform. And second is uniform motion. When a moving body covers equal distances in equal intervals of time, its motion is said to be uniform. And students, in everyday life, we seldom find objects moving with a constant speed over a long period of time. So, most of the moving objects that we observe around us are in non-uniform motion. Students, now let us revise what we have learned today. Question 1. Which of the following relations is correct? A. Speed equal to distance into time. B. Speed equal to distance upon time. C. Speed equal to time upon distance. D. Speed equal to 1 upon distance into time. And the right answer is B. Speed equal to distance upon time. Question 2. The basic unit of speed is A. Kilometer per minute. B. Meter per minute. C. Kilometer per hour. D. Meter per second. And the right answer is D. Meter per second. Question 3. If we denote speed by capital S, distance by capital D, and time by capital T, the relationship between these quantities is A. S equal D into T. B. T equal S upon D. C. S equal 1 upon T into D. D. T equal T by D. The right answer is C. S equal 1 upon T into D. Question 4. The distance travelled by a moving body in unit time is called its dash. A. Uniform motion. B. Non-uniform motion. C. Speed. D. Average speed. And the right answer is C. Speed. Practice makes perfect. Students, it's time to practice. And your practice homework are on your screens. See you soon in the next video of this chapter. Till then, take care and thank you for watching.